Hello everybody and welcome to Classic Car Republic, where we choose, use and review classic cars that might just be suitable for your garage. But not today, because today we are in Sandown on the Isle of Wight for the second annual Sandown Sprint.
In the summer, Sandown is a very popular destination, with families seeking out some of the spectacular sandy beaches of the Isle of Wight. But winter tends to be a little quieter, so an early start to the tourist season is always welcome. Competitors have travelled from across the UK to attend this year's event. And with the all clear from the course car, we're ready to go racing. After the resounding success of last year's inaugural event, it was no surprise at all to see an increase in competitors. There were 89 entrants, competing in 15 different classes, running everything from daily drivers, sports cars and supercars, track day specials, and rip-snorting monsters that wouldn't look out of place in the World Rally Championship, all competing for class wins and, of course, the ultimate honours. Speed and time trials offer a great way to get into motorsport, and with a few simple modifications, your standard road car can be made track-ready. Typified by Louise Wren in her Ford Puma on her way to taking second in class, beaten only by Neil Bateman in his beautifully prepared Renault Clio. It was great to see so many younger drivers making the start line, proving there is an abundance of talent making their way through the ranks, including Laura Lusted in her Toyota Starlet, proving that she's a talent worth keeping an eye on for the future. Classic Minis remain a crowd favourite, and even 62 years after their launch, they're still mixing it with the very best in the field, with Piers Thein taking first in class and Shane Parry taking third. The Mazda MX-5 has been on our roads for nearly 35 years, and pound for pound, remains one of the best handling sports cars you can buy. And that handling prowess was clear to see, as Ian Billett ably demonstrated. Last year, Will Nichols took the overall victory in his rally-prepared Ford Fiesta. But as James Shaw demonstrated, the Ford Fiesta is a fearsome competitor in any category, taking the class win in his 2013 Fiesta ST. It's over 60 years since the MGB was first launched, and has always been and remains a popular race car. Due to the anomalies of the classification process, it's hard for these cars to be competitive within their class. But nonetheless, it was great to see Glenn Sutton's GT and Gerald Wilby's Austin Healey being skillfully manoeuvred around the course. Roger Clark and Tony Mason ensured the legendary status was secured for the rally version of the Ford Escort Mark II. And seeing these free-revving, tail-happy, oversteering monsters being used in the manner for which they are designed is always a treat. Both Dave Benjamin and Simon May having a lot of fun out there, and Simon May rewarding his efforts with a class win. There can be few things better than taking your old British sports car out for a leisurely drive on a Sunday morning. But there was nothing leisurely about Michael Taylor's approach as he took his 1974 Morgan 4-4 around the course to secure second place in class. Last year's event was largely dominated by the fire-spitting turbocharger rally monsters of yesteryear, and Chris Stangle gave us an early indication of what was to come as he took the class victory in his Mitsubishi Evo 5. Despite the dry conditions, the gale force gusts provided enough of a tailwind to unsettle the unwary. Fortunately, the excellent marshals, all volunteers, were quickly on hand to ensure everybody's continued safety. By the end of the weekend, those barriers were starting to develop a persecution complex, and with some justification. It was an eclectic mix of cars, representing 84 years of automotive history, ranging from a 1938 20-horsepower Austin 7 to a fire-breathing 800 brake horsepower Subaru Legacy. No prizes for guessing which was faster, but both put an equal amount of smiles on people's faces. And from a spectator perspective, that's what this weekend was all about. Gordon Bushell's 1938 Austin 7 was a firm crowd favourite. With just 20 horsepower to push around the course, it was perhaps one of the slower cars. And with the appearance of sitting on it rather than in it, it all looked rather precarious. Nonetheless, it was a pleasure to see Gordon hustle this piece of automotive history around the course in the way that it was intended.
Seven.
Too quickly though, it's time for lunch, so we're going to take a quick break from the racing and join one of the competitors to see what they think of the event. Classic Car Republic is your one-stop shop for everything classic car. With over 130,000 products online, you're bound to find something you need and all at great prices. Additionally, you'll find cars for sale and a wealth of industry information, including car clubs, how many are left, and feature videos like this one on our YouTube channel.
So as I've already said, it's raining, so I've managed to find some shelter under a lovely bright orange gazebo, which I believe is brand new, and that belongs to Tim Simpson. And Tim has also brought his fabulous Westfield SEIW. SE, can you tell us a little bit about your car, please?
Sure. It's a 2008 Westfield SEIW. I didn't build it. I think I'm about the fifth owner. It's got a Ford Z-Tech engine from a Focus ST170, but it's been built up as a race engine. And I've had the car for about 3 years, I think.
So have you found the event this weekend? Have you enjoyed it?
And I think one of the best things about it is having the public here, having an audience to watch you. So, I mean, it's only a short course. I'm doing it in about 41 seconds, which is not the fastest here. Really good.
It's raining this weekend, and that changes everything. So have you gone onto a different type of tyre, and how's that going to impact your overall spin?
I'm on the same tyres as yesterday, so I'm on my dry tyres. I did bring some wet tyres, but they haven't been scrubbed in. I tried them in second practice yesterday, and they were like ice skates. So I'm not going to try them today. I'm just going to chance it and hope to get a dry run in this afternoon.
Well, as we can hear, there are engines starting all around us. So thank you very much for your time, Tim. Have a great day of racing today. And we'll let you get on and stay safe and put some great times in, despite the wet conditions.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.
And you can join us now with Tim Simpson in his car for one of his sighting laps. Super smooth driving from Tim Simpson, those Westfields look like a lot of fun. At the business end of the event, the competition did not disappoint, with Adam Mitchell taking a decisive class victory in his Ford Fiesta Rally 4. And out to prove that the classics can still mix it with the modern day monsters was Kevin Richardson in his Austin Mini from 1969, securing a deeply impressive second in class. Getting a lot of attention for all the right reasons was Simon Verstappen's 1981 Talbot Sunbeam 2-litre. This superbly prepared race car was an audible and visual delight, going on to take Simon a hard-earned second place in class. Mm-hmm. After coming second in last year's event by just 1/10 of a second overall, Demian Bradley was keen to make amends. And he did just that, taking his 1992 Subaru Legacy onto an overall win by more than 2 seconds. It's not every day you'll get to see a James Bond car go racing, so it was wonderful to see Nicholas Olsen's Lotus Esprit S3 on the course. Clearly Q had been hard at work because the car was a long way from standard, but it only added to the spectacle of the weekend. Another car with a fantastic provenance was Mick Strafford's Vauxhall Chevrolet Firenze Can-Am. Once owned by rally legend Jim McRae, father of Colin McRae, this 5-litre monster struggled to get the power down in the damp conditions, so if you can't be fast, well, you may as well have some fun. Will Nichols was the overall winner of last year's inaugural event, but with the changeable weather conditions and some more setup work to do on the car, Will would have to be satisfied with an emphatic class win rather than the overall victory. The prize for the loudest car of the weekend definitely went to John Peck's Ford Escort Cosworth as it popped and banged its way around the course to secure second place in class. What a monster! Classic Car Republic are delighted to have been official partners of this year's event, and we're proud to be associated with all the partners and volunteers who've worked so hard to make this event such a success. We understand from the organisers there are plans to increase spectator engagement and to improve the course for 2024. So as the circuit is officially closed for another year, we look forward to seeing you all in 2024. Classic Car Republic is your one-stop shop for everything classic car. With over 130,000 products online, you're bound to find something you need and all at great prices. Additionally, you'll find cars for sale and a wealth of industry information, including car clubs, how many are left, and feature videos like this one on our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching, and please join us again next time.